I'm extremely happy to be addressing you today in this very pious function. I call it as pious because this is the need of the hour. The country is moving forward, undoubtedly. We have made so much progress and we have many things to our credit. Since independence, we made a lot of progress. But one important challenge that is there in front of us, what is staring at us, is that more than one-fourth or one-third of the, around 30 crores population of the world who are illiterates, they are in India. It's a challenge to all of us, challenge to political leadership at the central level, at the state level, at the local body level, challenge to citizens of the country, that we must see to it that all these people are educated at the earliest. One is taking care of the school dropouts, that the governments are successfully doing it. I compliment them for the same. At the same time, educating the aged, educating the uneducated, whom we are calling illiterates, that's the sacred duty before all of us. I call it as a challenge because you cannot claim to be a developed country unless you have cent percent literacy. And you cannot call yourself as a welfare society unless everybody is educated. And you cannot expect everybody to get the fruits of development unless everybody is educated. Because education gives you knowledge. Education makes you to understand what are the programs and policies of the government. Education gets you your entitlement. It will make you to understand what is due for you. What are the schemes of the government? How do you get it? How do you reach it? All these things are possible only if you are educated. So we have to explain to those people, reach those people who are yet to be educated and focus on them. The successive governments have definitely taken up many programs. And also today is a special day dedicated to literacy that has been celebrated world over since the UNESCO accepted recommendations of the World Congress of Ministers of Education held at Tehran in 1965. This day reminds us of the importance of literacy in the developmental architecture of all countries and its crucial central role as a development accelerator. It is a day when we recollect our freedom struggle and the words of Mahatma Gandhi, who had said that mass illiteracy is a sin and shame which must be liquidated. This is the advice given by the father of the nation. It is a sin and it's a shame. This is not aimed at anybody, any party or any government or any this thing. It is aimed at the entire society. We must all take this as a sin. We must come out of it. And we must all take this as a challenge, as a shame that even after 70 years of independence, if you still have even 18% or 20% of the people not educated, that's a challenge to all of us. Because of the efforts made by successive governments, a lot of progress has been made. And we could reach from 18% in 1947, now we have reached 80%. It's really a great achievement. But at the same time, we cannot satisfy. We cannot rest ourselves on this front. Because as I told you, this is very much needed. I remember in my young age, teachers used to tell us to go to schools and village elders also used to tell us you have to go to school. And my grandfather told me in Telugu, in my mother tongue, he said, Chadu Rani Muddu Kadalaleni Yuddhu. That means, Jinko Siksha Aata Nahi, Wo Jaisa Aak Sota Hai Na Bull, Bull. Jo Chalne Ke Sthiti Mein Nahi Hai, To Bull Ka Fayda Kya Hai? Aisi, Jo Anpad Log Hai, Unka Sthiti Bhi Aisi Hai. Aisa Thoda Gaon Mein Ilaka Mein Thoda जोर देके ऐसा उदाहरण देते थे. गांव में जो भी उदाहरण हमारा पूर्वजों ने देते थे उसके पीछे बहुत तर्क और बहुत अर्थ थे. पावरफुल मैसेज भी था. सदूरानी मुद्दू कदल देनी यद्दू. अभी बुलेक्स को हम लोग यूज करते हैं ना प्लोविंग के लिए और बैलगाड़ी चलाने के लिए, मगर वो चलने की स्थिति में नहीं तो उसका फायदा क्या है? शिक्षा नहीं है तो फिर आदमी का फायदा क्या है? जन्म का सार्थकता क्या है? यही उसका संदेश है. इसलिए मित्रों, आज हम लोग जैसा भी मंत्री जी कह रहे थे, हर एक बच्चे पहले अपना माँ, अपना ग्रैंड माँ, ग्रैंड फादर, उन लोगों का शिक्षा के बारे में सोचना चाहिए, फोकस करना चाहिए। कारण कि बच्चे सब लोगों को स्कूल में ले जा रहे, और भी जोर से भी सरकार, आज का सरकार जो सबका साथ सबका विकास का काम लेकर चल रहे, पूरा प्रयास कर रहे, और इस प्रयास में सब लोग लगना चाहिए। केवल सरकार का काम नहीं है, सब काम सरकार करेगा, हम बेकार बैठे तो चलेगा, ये चलेगा भी नहीं है। कारण क्या है, देश के विकास में हम लोग भागीदारी होना चाहिए, हर एक व्यक्ति, हर एक नागरिक, हर एक सज्जन अपना योगदान करना चाहिए। एज वी मूव फॉरवर्ड, वी रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन अवर प्रोग्रेस ओवर द 70 years, पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू सो एलोक्वेंटली पुट इट एट द मिडनाइट ऑफ 15th August 1947, टू ब्रिंग फ्रीडम एंड अपॉर्चुनिटी टू कॉमन मैन, टू क्रिएट सोशल, इकोनॉमिक एंड पोलिटिकल इंस्टीट्यूशन विच विल एंश्योर जस्टिस एंड फुलनेस ऑफ लाइफ टू एवरी मैन एंड वुमन। लाइफ इज इनकम्प्लीट विदाउट एजुकेशन। एज वी टेक स्टॉक ऑफ वॉट वी हैव अचीव्ड ओवर द ईयर्स, वी कैन लुक बैक विथ प्राइड एट द मेनी माइल स्टोन्स वी हैव क्रॉस इन अवर जर्नी। एज आई टोल्ड यू फ्रेंड्स, वी हैव मेड लॉट ऑफ प्रोग्रेस। Over 95% of children are in schools, 95-98 ministry is saying, and nearly 86% of young people are functionally literate. It is not a small achievement. However, we have to draw inspiration from our past success and move forward in the years to come to face the challenge. We certainly have a long way to go. We cannot ignore the fact that today, as I told you, around 30 crore youth and adults are outside the literate world, and therefore are unable to participate effectively in contemporary India's development growth. Development has no meaning without literacy. Democracy has no meaning without literacy. Swaraj ka koi ardh nahi hai jab tak har ek nagarik sakshar ke saath unko nahi judenge, fir uska koi ardh nahi hai. Add to this, 40% of our school children are not acquiring basic literary skills proficiently, even though after completing the cycle of elementary education. ये भी एक महत्वपूर्ण विषय है। We have a formidable challenge that needs to be recognized and systematically addressed. Today provides an opportunity for us to celebrate our collective achievements, and it's an inspiring saga of untiring efforts. Many individuals and institutions have contributed to this national effort. The enlightened rulers of the country Travancore, Baroda, for example, they have expanded education opportunities at that time. Inspired by Mahatma Gandhi, Wilde Fisher and Lobach set up a literacy house in Lucknow in 1953. There were active campaigns for adult literacy like Gram Shikshan Muhim in 1959. Excellent momentum was generated through the Government of India's National Literacy Mission. Thanks to the efforts, nearly 3/4 of our population today can read and write. However, the challenge remains. Time and again, I am repeating, the challenge remains. And it acquires a sense of urgency in the current Indian and global context. The government believes, as the Prime Minister Modi ji has reiterated BRICS conference at Yuan, China on 5th September, quote, "The bedrock of our development agenda lies in the notion of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, that is corrective effort, inclusive growth. Unless you are educated, you will not be able to fight against corruption. You will not be able to fight against discrimination. You will not be able to fight against injustice that is meted out to you. So that's why everybody needs to be educated. The country is also embarking on a faster development trajectory to shape a new India in the next 5 years. Globally, we have committed to the implementation of 2030 Agenda of Sustainable Development by all nations at the United Nations January 2016. That was the resolve. The global agenda envisages a world with universal literacy, and one of the targets set in the agenda to be achieved by 2030 is specially focused on youth and adult literacy. Target 4.6 of the Sustainable Development Goal is as follows. By 2030, ensure that all youth and substantial portion of adults, both men and women, achieve literacy, numeracy. If you have to move faster pace and achieve a literate world by 2030, and India has to ensure that all youth and substantial portion of adults acquire these skills. We may have to review our past strategies and after an assessment of what has worked, what has not, learn from the successful examples from within our country and outside, we may have to chalk out new ways to reach out to those learners who have not been reached till now. Clearly, this has to be a collective effort. It has to be a societal mission with a clear understanding of the characteristic role literacy can play in shaping a new India. I recall the words of famous Telugu poet Gurujada Apparao, who said, Desam ante matti kadoi, desam ante manushuloi. He said, country is not land under our feet, but it is the people who live in the land. It is the quality of life of the people which characterize the country. It is the quality that determines how fruits of development are shared. We have a commitment to increase your growth. We are consciously adopted the Antyodaya approach, that is the reaching out to the poorest of the poor. Antima pankti mein jo baithe, unka uttan, ye hamara pradhamikta hona chahiye. Ye sarkar ka agenda bhi hai. Magar us agenda ko saksham roop mein amal karne ke liye pura deshvasi isme shamil hona chahiye. Mitro, against the backdrop and underlying guiding principles of Sabka Vikas, it is obvious literacy provides the first essential step towards building a participative, vibrant and a more inclusive democracy. Literacy helps individuals to access and exercise various rights, entitlements provided to them under the Constitution. It is seen that problems like poverty, infant mortality, population growth, gender inequality are better resolved by a literate society. Besides being stepping stone for all forms of formal learning as well as lifelong education, literacy enables individuals to access and avail economic, political and social benefits. In the Indian context, literacy can play an important role of empowering, transforming, improving quality of life and individuals as well as society. The Prime Minister gave a call of, he said, reform, perform and transform. I was IMB Minister, I added inform. Reform, perform, transform and inform the people. So you have to take the society into confidence of what we are doing. So we have to achieve this universal goal and we must adopt two-pronged approach. First is, we must improve the quality of pre-primary and school education. Second, we must provide opportunities for learning to those who have never been to school or have dropped out of the school. Keeping in view the importance of the literacy in individual life and society as a whole, the Government of India has adopted Sakshara Bharat and Sarva Siksha Abhiyan as the key programs, instruments which are being implemented in the country. Isliye bhaiyo evam behno, Bharat ka sampurna vikas ke liye Bharat ki janta ka sakshar hona bahut jaruri hai. पुरुषों के साथ महिलाओं को भी साक्षर होना होगा. यह जानकर अत्यंत प्रसन्नता हुई कि कुछ स्टेट्स में ये महिला लिटरेसी रेट बहुत तेजी से आगे बढ़ रही. कारण क्या है, जब माँ लिटरेट हो गया तो पूरा परिवार में लिटरेसी आएगा. द साक्षरता प्रोग्राम इज प्राइमरली फोकस्ड ऑन प्रमोशन ऑफ लिटरेसी इन रूरल एरियाज एज लो फीमेल लिटरेसी डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स एंड दिस हैज हेल्प्ड इन एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशनल फ्रेमवर्क at panchayat level. I am glad the focus has been on female literacy because its potential multiplier. I also firmly believe that this learned assessment tests held across the country and around 6.66 crore learners have successfully passed the assessment test conducted by the National Institute of Open Schooling up to March 2017, of which 70% are women. That's a happy news. I firmly believe that these neo-literates, majority of whom are women, will be ambassadors of our program leading towards making Sakshara Bharat a Saksham Bharat. I am happy to learn that the National Literacy Mission Authority is not only engaged in imparting basic literacy to the adult learners, but also ventured into forging convergence and partnership with various agencies to link literacy with our dimensions and economic development like electoral, financial and legal literacy, primarily amongst the rural people. I am told that under financial literacy, a special drive was undertaken in Sakshar Bharat districts to mobilize more than 1 crore Sakshar Bharat learners to open up and operate their bank accounts under Pradhan Mantri Jana Dhana Yojana. We also participated in the Sakshar Bandhan drive for Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bhima Yojana. state partners such as letter of the missions, authorities, state resource centers, Janasikshana Samsthans, successfully motivated over 1 crore beneficiaries. We have just now seen, I am very happy, that states like Telangana, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, jahan Janasikshana Samsthan, aur baaki log jo kaam kar rahe hain, hum logon ko humne puraskar diya. Yes, my Karan ka isi ilake mein jo area so called backward hai uske upar zyada focus dena chahiye. Aaj ka jo puraskar grahita hai unme se zyada sa log in ilake se aa rahe hain. Ye to ek acha khabar hai. Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Orissa, in ilakon ke upar zyada focus bhi karna chahiye. Karan kya hai wahan comparatively, but mujhe प्रसन्नता हो रही है जब बुला रहे थे एक के बाद एक बुला रहे छत्तीसगढ़ 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 ऐसा छत्तीसगढ़ तेजी से आगे बढ़ रहे और नया बना तेलंगाना स्टेट भी आगे बढ़ रहे ये भी खुशी का बात है और बिहार भी पीछा नहीं है ये पहले लोग कहते थे सब बीमारू स्टेट्स है बिहार मध्य प्रदेश राजस्थान उत्तर प्रदेश ये बीमारू अभी बीमारू नहीं है बीमार से बाहर आया मगर तेजी से आगे बढ़ना चाहिए बिकॉज देश और तेजी से आगे बढ़ रहे दुनिया भी आगे बढ़ रही तो दुनिया के साथ हम दौड़ना है तो उसके लिए विशेष प्रयास जिन कमजोर इलाका है उस इलाके के बारे में ज्यादा हम लोग फोकस करना चाहिए मित्रों इसलिए मैंने देखा खुद अनुभव किया जब मैं राजनीतिक क्षेत्र में था एमपी था एमएलए था मंत्री था दो महिला सशक्ति समूह सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स उस मूवमेंट के कारण से भी साक्षरता को ज्यादा बल मिला है उन लोगों ने इसमें ज्यादा रुचि लिया है और ग्राम पंचायत लेवल पर हर एक सरपंच अपना गांव में कोई अनपढ़ व्यक्ति है क्या वो पहला प्राथमिकता उनका वो होना चाहिए उनको कैसा साक्षर बनने के लिए प्रयास करना सरपंच का पहला दायित्व होता है स्वच्छ भारत प्रधानमंत्री जनधन योजना पीएम सुरक्षा बीमा योजना पीएम उज्ज्वला योजना बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ डिजिटल इंडिया मिशन स्किल इंडिया मिशन ये सब सभी सार्थक होगा जब हम साक्षर हो जाएंगे इसलिए सब मिशंस को भी देयर हैज टू बी सॉर्ट ऑफ ए कोऑपरेशन एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन बिटवीन दिस ऑल दीज मिशंस एंड इट्स टाइम फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस टू कलेक्टिवली थिंक एंड टेक अप दिस चैलेंज वेरी सीरियसली I am told that the Human Resource Ministry has decided to redesign Sakshar Bharat program to make it more focused and ensure that all children and youth and adults acquire literacy and numerical skills required for more effective functioning by 2022. If you are really able to do it, Prakash ji, you will go down and the government will go down in the history of the country. If you are able to achieve this mission of 2022, literally making everybody literate. So we must use the technology to make the literary programs more effective. Digital learning materials can address the diverse learning needs of different age groups. Literacy learning can be made more meaningful if it is linked to the daily lives of the learners. Community learning centers can become the hubs of literacy learning and community empowerment. I am glad to note that India is part of the UNESCO's led initiative called the Global Alliance for Literacy within the framework of lifelong learning. Before I conclude, I would like to congratulate all those who received the Sakshar Bharat Awards for their outstanding contribution. As I told you, this felicitation is to give inspiration to others. Why we have felicitated these people is to give inspiration to others that they should also move in that direction. Good work done by the awardees can be an inspiration to others to carry forward the program in other gram panchayats, districts and states. I take this opportunity to call upon all the stakeholders, including state governments, civil society organizations, NGOs, corporate bodies, and intelligentsia, and my fellow citizens to join hands in transforming India to a fully literate society. I would like to exhort all the stakeholders, beneficiaries in the field of literary to fulfill the vision of Mahatma Gandhi, the founding fathers of the Constitution. Let us create a new India, built on the strengthened base of literate, educated, empowered population. Let us realize that heaven of freedom dreamt by Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore, where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, when the knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. This is what Gurudev ji has said.